सेक्शन 124 ए आईपीसी इज़ अ थ्रेट टू फंडामेंटल राइट्स। प्ली इन सुप्रीम कोर्ट चैलेंजेस द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल वैलिडिटी ऑफ सेडिशन लॉ। अ प्ली हैज़ बीन फाइल्ड बिफोर द सुप्रीम कोर्ट अर्जिंग इट टू डिक्लेयर द लॉ अगेंस्ट सेडिशन अंडर सेक्शन 124 ए ऑफ द इंडियन पिनल कोड एज अल्ट्रा वायर्स द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन of India. The plea states that a colonial provision like section 124A, which was intended to subjugate the subjects of British Crown, should not be permitted to continue in a democratic republic under the continuously expanding scope of the fundamental rights. The petitioners advocate Aditya Ranjan, Varun Thakur and V. Elen Shinjia have filed the plea, being aggrieved by the increased chilling effect of blatant misuse of section 124A of IPC on the constitutional democracy and on the fundamental rights, and under article 19 sub clause 1 clause A and article 21, they are also aggrieved by the indiscriminate and unlawful use of the sedition law against journalists, women, children, students and other persons in clear defiance of the interpretation given by the Apex Court of India. The plea filed through Advocate Sanjay Kumar Pathak has stated that while democratic principles have evolved, Section 124A of IPC, which is a relic of the colonial era, is still stifling the freedom of speech and expression in India and threatening the life and liberty of citizens of India if they choose to express dissent against policies of the government in power. According to the petition, the continuance of draconian colonial provision like 124 clause A in the penal code without corresponding safeguards as provided under the Unlawful Activities Prevention Act is unreasonable and unwarranted. The law doesn't lay down an institutional responsibility on the police in case of misuse, and no procedural safeguards are available under the Code of Criminal Procedure, unlike the Unlawful Activities Prevention Act. Therefore, Section 124 Clause A needs to be examined under the changed facts and circumstances, and also on the and will of ever evolving test of necessity, proportionality and arbitrariness. The plea has cited the Supreme Court's observation in the case of Balwant Singh versus State of Punjab, where court had clarified that merely shouting slogans, in this case Khalistan Jindabad, does not amount to sedition. A top court in the case of Common Cause versus Union of India had directed that we are of the considered opinion that the authorities, while dealing with the offences under Section 124A of the Indian Penal Code 1860, shall be guided by the principles laid down by the Constitution Bench in Kedarnath Singh versus State of Bihar, citing the Apex Court's order in case of Shreya Singhal versus Union of India, where it had held that a speech should be considered as a whole in a free, fair and liberal spirit. The plea states that the police across the country is picking a part of the speech or expression to invoke Section 124 Clause A against the citizens, that too without examining the proximate and direct nexus of the act. Mere slapping of charge of sedition against a citizen endangers the right to live with dignity of the person and his family members forever. The media portrays the person charged as Deshdrohi, whereas the seditious activities are imputed against the government, and in Hindi it may translate into Rajdroh, which is not the same as Deshdroh. It causes chilling effect on other citizens and prevent them from exercising their fundamental right to criticize the government and its policies through legitimate means. According to the petitioners, the right to question, criticize and change the public representatives and the government from time to time without resorting to violence is very fundamental to the idea of democracy. But the sedition law under Section 124A is a constant threat to the fundamental rights of millions, including the petitioners. The plea has alternatively sought directions to the government to instruct their respective heads of public and DGPs to ensure that the law as set forth by the Supreme Court in the Kedarnath case and Balwant Singh case, including the following observations, are strictly followed. Written or spoken words, etc., which have implicit in them the idea of subverting the subverting government by violent means alone have been made penal. Section 124A IPC. The police should act with great sensitivity and refrain from arresting citizens merely for raising stray slogans without creating any adverse law and order situation. Raising of some slogans without anything more cannot constitute any threat to the government of India as by law established, nor can the same give rise to feelings of enmity or hatred among different communities or religious or other groups. Any speech should be considered as a whole in a free, fair and liberal spirit. Thank you.